Steve Hartman from CBS News is known for his very popular On the Road series.
Now during the COVID-19 outbreak, he's offering a special live online course called Kindness 101. So happy to have Steve joining us now live on Skype. Steve, thanks for being with us. We know you have a strong Minneapolis connection to the start of your, the early days of your career, right?
Yeah, it's simply one of my favorite places on earth. That's my connection.
It's a solid one.
You are correct.
It's a solid one. Tell us why you had this idea of starting the Kindness 101 class. What was the thought here?
Well, we've been hearing for years that teachers were using our stories in the classroom as part of their character education program. And so when this crisis struck, we thought, what could we do to help? And I thought there's two things the world needs more of, and that is character education for our children and babysitting. So I combined those two things that I started this class so that one parents would have a half hour where they could just sit the kids in front of the screen and they could learn a little something that will prove very valuable once all this is over.
So you're doing this class each day this week or through Thursday this week online with your own kids, which really makes it so much more fun. And each day has a different theme. I loved yesterday's day of character. And I'm wondering what, if you haven't seen it yet, what you sort of hope that these kids will take away from that.
Well, yesterday we talked about character. We're going to talk about empathy. We're going to talk about altruism. Today is actually about empathy. And what I want kids to take away from this is we're always asking kids, you know, what do you want to be when you grow up? This class, if I could sum it up, it's about asking kids, how do you want to be when you grow up? What kind of person do you want to be? So we're talking each day about different characteristics that I think are important to make for good kids, good adults. And I think it doesn't matter when all is said and done, if the kids know what the capital of North Dakota is, Bismarck, by the way, it matters what kind of person they are. And if they're a good, solid person that can be honest, can be trusted, and is kind to others, I think everything else falls into place.
Isn't that interesting, Steve? My mom, before, when my wife was pregnant, with our oldest now, who is 14, said that my job as a parent is not to create a good kid or to create a straight A student. My job is to create a good adult. Mm-hmm. And it's just a very subtle shift in thinking that does have me focused more on what kind of human are you going to be? And that, I think, is sometimes difficult here in America, where we're so focused on things like test scores and achievement and athletics and how many ribbons can you get, that there is no ribbon for empathy. Although sometimes maybe I feel like getting a story done on you by Steve Hartman maybe is that ribbon. I think you try to highlight those stories every week.
Yeah, I couldn't agree more. It matters what kind of adult you are. And I remember when I was growing up, parents would always, you know, they push you to be a doctor or a lawyer. They wouldn't push you to be an empathetic person. At least my parents didn't, but they obviously did something right. But I think that's the exact right approach. Your mother was very smart, which, are you adopted or how do we explain all that?
I know, it's a fair question. I mean, I was fighting her all the way. It took a while until I realized that she was 100% right.
Steve, you in your life and in your career have been lucky enough to run into all kinds of wonderful stories of kindness, and you share them in this class and with these kids. I'm wondering, from all of these stories that you've learned, what advice can you give to us for us to be kind, even just today or tomorrow or the next day?
Well, the overarching theme of my career, the big discovery of my life, has been that people are good. I started discovering that during this Everybody Has a Story series I did, where I picked people at random out of the phone book, threw a dart at a map, went there, picked people at random out of the phone book, and did a story on them. And time after time after time, I just kept getting these really great people. Americans are good, and we start to see that especially at times like this. I often say that, you know, most Americans are heroes just waiting for their moment. And sometimes it's the military, now it's the doctors and the nurses and the scientists. But we're all heroes just waiting for that time to step up. And I'm telling the kids that right now is their time. that they can step up and be kind. And what these first responders need, the doctors, the nurses, the garbage men, the people that are working in the restaurants, is they need thank yous. So the only homework assignment that I'm giving kids during the class is to find somebody and say thank you. Write a letter, make a phone call, but thank somebody who is a hero today.
Yeah, it's so simple, but so powerful.
Right.
So powerful. Steve, thank you, very much. I think this is great. All the parents who are watching Mid-Morning can go to Steve Hartman's Kindness 101. It's on Facebook, of course, America's number one home for kindness, which is Facebook, I think. Trying to turn that around a little bit.
1 by
p.m.
One.
Right? How are you keeping things kind on Facebook, Steve?
Well, Matt, I can't control all of Facebook.
Right.
But if they go to the CBS Evening News with Nora O'Donnell Facebook page, the nice thing about, you can access this through a lot of platforms, but if you go there, I can see your comments.
Right.
I can see when you're asking questions, and so it's a little more interactive that way. But regardless, find some way in joining us at 1 o'clock.
Yeah. And if you want to see Steve's kids read your comments, you can find that there too. All right. And be sure to watch Steve on Friday night, this Friday night, with a story about all this on the CBS Evening News with Nora O'Donnell.
Thanks, Steve.
It was a pleasure to talk with you, Steve. Thank you.
Thank you.
Yeah.